Good morning, students. Today we have a new topic to discuss, which is law of flotation. So according to law of flotation, when a body floats in a liquid, then the weight of liquid displaced by its immersed part is equal to total weight of the liquid. Now, as you know that when we place an object, then object will float with some of its part inside, or can be the whole part inside. So that is called the immersed part. So the weight of the liquid displaced by its immersed part will always be equal to the weight of the total weight of the liquid. This is called law of flotation. So we can write weight of floating body is equal to buoyant force. Because this weight of the immersed part of a liquid is only called the buoyant force. So what amount of buoyant force has been applied by the liquid on the object placed inside? Okay, it all depends upon the weight of the liquid displaced by the And you should know one more thing, that whenever a body is floating in a liquid, then it gets a new weight, which is always lighter than when the body is in the air or when it is not placed in water. So that new weight that a body acquires when it is placed inside water is called apparent weight. So for a floating body, the apparent weight will always be equal to zero. So we can write apparent weight. Apparent weight of a floating body is always equal to zero. And one more thing you should know here, that weight of the liquid displaced by the immersed part of a body will always be more for a liquid whose density is less. And if a liquid has a more density, then weight of a liquid displaced will also be less. Let us try to understand this with the help of one small activity. Say there is a liquid in this tank. This is liquid A, and I am taking another tank where liquid B is taken. So here we can assume that liquid A has density less than liquid B. Let us now see what happened if the same body is placed in both the liquids one by one. So for a body whose density you can see, so in this case you can see we have liquid A having density less than liquid B. So if the same body is placed in both the liquids, both are not going to, in both cases the solid is not going to immerse equally in both the liquids. Okay, so in this case, because the density of this liquid A is less, so it is found that the solid will have more of its part immersed. So major portion will be inside water. But in this case, since the density of liquid is more, then in this case the part of a body immersed inside this liquid will be less. So what amount of body will be inside the liquid, what amount it will be outside, that all depends upon the density of the liquid. And then we have some applications of flotation. First is flotation of an iron sheet. Now it is well known that when an iron, small piece of iron is placed in water, then it sinks. But the ship, which is made up of so many nails, it does not sink. What is the reason? The reason is that when ship is made, of course nails are used to make it, but at the same time it contains other materials also, like wood, hollow pipes, sometimes bamboos are used. So making the average density of the ship altogether less than water. So as a result, ship, even though it is very large, it does not sink in water, it floats in water, but the small piece of iron looks very small, but because its density is more than water, it sinks in it. Next, flotation of man. You know that it is easier to swim in sea water than in river water. The reason is because the density of sea water is more than density of river water. So a person has to immerse less part of his body inside sea water so it can easily be balanced, and a person can easily swim in sea water. But in river water, because its density is less, so the large portion of a person's body has to be immersed inside, okay, so that weight of the liquid displaced will become equal to weight of the body. So as a result, we find that it is not so easy to swim in river water, because most of the part of the body will be inside water. Next, flotation of ice on water. As we know, density of ice is less than density of water. Density of ice is around 900 kg per meter cube, whereas density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube. So due to this less density of ice, when ice is placed in water, it floats in it. But 9/10, around 9/10 part will be inside water, and only 1/10 part of the ice will be outside water. It means to say that weight of liquid displaced will be by the 9/10 part of the ice. And hence ice will be floating in water with major portion of it inside water. Now submarine. You know, submarine is like a ship, a big ship, but unlike the ship, submarine can be taken inside, or it can be also allowed to float on the water. Now how can it be done that sometimes it can be taken inside and it can be taken out of water also? So submarine has got two tanks. Whenever submarine has to dive inside, these two tanks are to be filled with water. So to make the average density of submarine more than water, and when it becomes more, slowly it goes inside water. Now when the same submarine has to be taken out, then in that case water from the water tanks has to be released, making the average density less, due to which slowly submarine will rise and will come on the top of water. So these are the applications of flotation. Hope you have understood it, and you should also learn these applications. Thank you.